Hello there, YouTube. I am NecroStevo, and today I present to you the Pokedex entries from every Pokemon introduced in Diamond and Pearl, or the Sinnoh region. If you enjoy, of course, please leave a like, and this is just going to be our lead up to the re-release, or the remake, of Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl in November. Ideally, I'll get up a couple of these each week, and I would appreciate some feedback on the format if you enjoy these videos. Once we're done uploading every single one, there will be a final upload that has all these Pokemon in one video. If you truly enjoy this, of course, let me know, and I look forward to hopefully doing other Pokedex entries for other regions in the future. For now, let's get comfortable and go through the Pokedex for Pokemon who were introduced in the Sinnoh region. Number 387, Turtwig, the tiny leaf Pokemon. Made from soil, the shell on its back hardens when it drinks water. It lives along lakes. It undertakes photosynthesis with its body, making oxygen. The leaf on its head wilts if it's thirsty. The shell on its back is made of soil. On a very healthy Turtwig, the shell should feel moist. Photosynthesis occurs across its body under the sun, and the shell on its back is actually hardened soil. Number 388, Grottle, the Grove Pokemon. It lives along water in forests. In the daytime, it leaves the forest to sunbathe its treed shell. The shell is hardened soil. Some Pokemon come to peck the berries growing on the trees on its back. It knows where pure water wells up, and it carries fellow Pokemon there on its back. Number 389, Torterra, the Continent Pokemon. Small Pokemon occasionally gather on its unmoving back to begin building their nests. Groups of this Pokemon migrating in search of water have been mistaken for moving forest. Some Pokemon are born on Torterra's back and spend their entire life there. Ancient people imagined that beneath the ground, a gigantic Torterra dwelt. Number 390, Chimchar, the Chimp Pokemon. It agilely scales sheer cliffs to live atop craggy mountains. Its fire is put out when it sleeps. Its fiery rear end is fueled by gas made in its belly. Even rain can't extinguish the fire. It is very agile. Before going to sleep, it extinguishes the flame on its tail to prevent fires. The gas made in its belly burns from its rear end. The fire burns weakly when it feels sick. Number 391, Monferno, the Playful Pokemon. To intimidate attackers, it stretches the fire on its tail to make itself appear bigger. It uses ceilings and walls to launch aerial attacks. Its fiery tail is but one weapon. It skillfully controls the intensity of the fire on its tail to keep its foes at an ideal distance. A bigger fire on its tail and a bright blue pattern on its face means its rank in the pack is higher. Number 392, Infernape, the Flame Pokemon. It uses a special kind of martial arts involving all of its limbs. Its fire never goes out. Its crown of fire is indicative of its fiery nature. It is beaten by none in terms of quickness. It uses unique fighting moves with fire on its hands and feet. It will take on any opponent. It tosses its enemies around with its agility. It uses all of its limbs to fight in its own unique style. Number 393, Piplup, the Penguin Pokemon. Because it is very proud, it hates accepting food from people. Its thick down guards it from cold. It lives along shores in northern countries. A skilled swimmer, it dives for over 10 minutes to hunt. A poor walker, it often falls down. However, its strong pride makes it puff up its chest without a care. It doesn't like to be taken care of. It's difficult to bond with since it won't listen to its trainer. Number 394, Prinplup, the penguin Pokemon. It lives alone, away from others. Apparently, every one of them believes it is the most important. Its wings deliver wicked blows that snap even the thickest of trees. It searches for prey in icy seas. Because every Prinplup considers itself to be the most important, they can never form a group. It lives a solitary life. Its wings deliver wicked blows that can snap even the thickest of trees. Number 395, Empoleon, the Emperor Pokemon. The three horns that extend from its beak attest to its power. The leader has the biggest horns. It swims as fast as a jet boat. The edges of its wings are sharp and can slice apart drifting ice. If anyone were to hurt its pride, it would slash them with wings that can cleave through an ice floe. It avoids unnecessary disputes, but it will decimate anything that threatens its pride. Starly, the starling Pokemon. They flock in great numbers. Though small, they flap their wings with great power. Usually with a large flock, it is barely noticeable when alone. Its cries are very strident. Because they are weak individually, they form groups. However, they bicker if the group grows too big. They flock around mountains and fields, chasing after bug Pokemon. Their singing is noisy and annoying. Number 397, Staravia, the starling Pokemon. It flies around forests and fields in search of bug Pokemon. It stays within a huge flock. It lives in forests and fields. Squabbles over territory occurs when flocks collide. Recognizing their own weakness, they always live in a group. When alone, a Staravia cries noisily. They maintain huge flocks, although fierce scuffles break out between various flocks. Number 398, Staraptor, the predator Pokemon. It has a savage nature. It will courageously challenge foes that are much larger. The muscles in its wings and legs are strong. It can easily fly while gripping a small Pokemon. It never stops attacking even if it's injured. It fusses over the shape of its comb. When Staravia evolve into Staraptor, they leave the flock to live alone. They have sturdy wings. Number 399, Bidoof, the plump mouse Pokemon. With nerves of steel, nothing can perturb it. It is more agile and active than it appears. It constantly gnaws on logs and rocks to whittle down its front teeth. It nests alongside water. A comparison revealed that Bidoof's front teeth grow at the same rate as Rattata's. It lives in groups by the water. It chews up boulders and trees around its nest with its incisors. Number 400, Bibberell, the beaver Pokemon. It makes its nest by damming streams with bark and mud. It is known as an industrious worker. While its movements out of water are sluggish, it can swim as fast as any Phoebus. A river dammed by Bibberell will never overflow its banks, which is appreciated by people nearby. It busily makes its nest with stacks of branches and roots it has cut up with its sharp incisors. Alright, so thank you all so much for making it to the end of this first video for the Pokedex entries of the original Diamond, Pearl, Platinum, and Heart Gold Soul Silver entries for all Pokemon introduced in the Sinnoh region. Again, if you enjoyed it, make sure you leave a like and give me some feedback. What was some Pokemon or Pokemon fact that you did not know? Because how many of us actually go in and read all these fascinating Pokedex entries in the game? They put a lot of work into these, and it's always interesting to see what comes out of them. Of course, thank you to Stariana for the background used in this video. And I appreciate you all and your attention. Look forward to the next video soon. Thanks so much. Have a great day.